All right, Rabbi Osai, good morning. Let us begin. We are beginning a beautiful new Os this morning in Tzidkas HaTzadik, Os Mem Zayin. So the Rebbe says as follows. Let's actually, if it's all right, let's begin by taking a look in the Be'uri HaChassidus, and at least for the introductory paragraph, taking kind of going on the journey from there. So the Rebbe writes as follows. La'or Mashin is Ba'er Ba'os HaKodemes. Remember again in the last os, where although we didn't do the entire os, we saw the essence of the Rebbe's theme, more than the essence, we saw the Rebbe's theme of Koma Shioma Lacha Balabayis Asei Chutz Mitse. In general, whatever the Balabayis Sever HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells you to do, you have to do, with the exception of get out. So if HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells you, you have to get out, you have to go in on a relationship that you don't have to listen to. So Reb Tzadik described that as chutzpah. Chutzpah, it's a chutzpah we find the first time by the ma'apilin. Right? Remember again, the individuals who ignored the directive of Moshe Rabbeinu not to ascend Teretz Yisrael, because again, they felt, even though HaKadosh Baruch Hu was telling them, don't come in, we don't have to listen if the Ribono Shel Olam tells us, don't come. So that's the chutzpah. Reb Tzadik described this as a dramatic chutzpah. So Reb Tzadik says, and again, a chutzpah, I don't know what the good English word for chutzpah is, an arrogance, a sense of hubris, but it's not really an arrogance, it doesn't really need a translation. Good, so the Rebbe says as follows, L'or mashin isbar ba'osak odemes, shegam b'midas ha'chutzpah, yesh la'odam l'shtamish l'tova. So again, as Rebbe explained in the previous Os, that there is a positive use for chutzpah. There is a positive use for chutzpah. Yisba'er kan, shekein hu b'chol hamidos utchunos nafsho shala adam. This is true regarding all of the different character traits and attributes that a person possesses. Meaning, the same way that if you were to ask someone, is chutzpah a good trait or not a good trait? Chutzpah is not a good trait. Chutzpah, we would say chutzpah, right? We teach our children from the time that they're young not to have chutzpah, not to talk with chutzpah, not to behave with chutzpah. Adults that have chutzpah, generally we try to steer away from. And yet again, we learned in the previous Os that chutzpah has a very powerful and positive use. So the Rebbe says that becomes a paradigm, that every midah that a person possesses, ultimately again, could go ahead and be used for good. B'chola kochos, tchunos anefesh, every single koach, every single, and when he says koach, koach means a strength, koach means a character trait, an attribute, every koach that a person possesses, afilo b'kas, even anger, gaiva, arrogance, taiva, desire, hanetulos b'chol nefesh mi'yisra, ba'ofen tivi, that are often embedded in our nature, that are often embedded in our nature, in lachshov ashum koach utchuna mitchuna sanefesh shehura gomer. This is incredibly profound, and this is probably one of the tenet teachings of Chassidus. A person should never think of any character trait or attribute as bad. There's no such thing as a bad character trait or attribute. Umameila yesh l'tchosol gamre. Or I should say, there's no such thing as a bad koach. There's no such thing as a bad energy. I'm going to have to choose my words a little bit better. We'll use the word right now. There's no such thing as a bad trait, but we're going to refine that a little bit more. Rather, he says, So what the Rebbe is saying is like this. I'll give you the punchline, and then you're going to see ultimately how we'll work back into it. What the Rebbe is working off is like this. Once you tell me in Os Mem Vav, like we learned before, that chutzpah is a good trait, so the Rebbe says that's a dramatic and startling revelation. Because I would have said, I've always been conditioned to think that chutzpah is not a good thing. But now what I'm beginning to see is maybe there's no such thing as good things, or good traits, bad traits, but instead what there is energy. And everything depends on how you channel that energy. So we'll say, just using chutzpah for just a moment. So chutzpah in general would say, good or bad? Yes, most people, chutzpah, good or bad? They're going to say, bad, right? Bad. Yet we Reb Tzadok says that's not true. It depends how you use it. If you use chutzpah in the way you interact with other people, probably bad. But amazingly enough, if you use chutzpah with the Ribono Shel Olam, that even when HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells you, go away, I don't want a relationship, you say, I'm coming anyway, good. So everything is how you frame it. And the Rebbe says, again, we'll drill down to this a little bit. The Rebbe now expands this to say, you know what? This is true. Bichol hakochos hanatuos bichol nefesh Yisrael. Any koach, any strength you have, and our strengths manifest themselves in different ways. They manifest themselves in traits, in characteristics, in behaviors. There is no such thing as a bad koach. There is just misapplied kochos. There is correctly utilized kochos, correctly channeled kochos, and misapplied kochos. And this is important. Before the Rebbe gives more examples of this, this is very important because the Rebbe says what this teaches us is a very important lesson. Is a very important. We'll say, a person should never think, this is incredibly important, and I will say, actually, we're going to see a little bit controversial. So it says, a person should never think that there is some koach in him that he has to fully eradicate. There's a koach I have that is just not good and needs to be fully eradicated. Ulahachlit shetzarech lios hefcho shel hakoach ahu. Kigon, sha'achzar yesh lo lios rachamon ukidom v'chol shara midos. We'll say, let's say, for example, in the Baruch Hashem, he says, let's say someone is an achzar. Achzar means someone who is cruel and indifferent. So a person might say, well, being cruel and indifferent is a terrible midah, is a terrible thing. So that a person like that really has to work on becoming a rachamon, totally compassionate. Sadek says that's not how we address things, because there's no such thing, like Sadek is saying, is a bad koach. The whole secret to success in life is not changing yourself, it's channeling yourself. It's not change, it's channeling. In fact, what we're going to see is one of the reasons why so many of us, or some of us, I'll just talk about myself, some of us, right here in the shul, in the basement this morning, some of us have difficulty achieving real changes because we actually think that the goal is to become the opposite of something. I'm this right now, this is not good, so I have to become this, which is the opposite. And it's almost impossible to become the opposite of who you are. And that's why so many times we think that, you know, here I am, change is this. And change looks so dramatically different than who I am right now. Now, it could very well be that I have to become someone dramatically different, but it's not through becoming the opposite of what I am now. It's by identifying the kochos, figuring out where I'm misapplying those kochos, and figuring out how to rechannel things in a better way. It sounds nuanced, but it's so incredibly profound. And just from an intellectual perspective, I will say, telling yourself, it's not that I have to become someone new. It's not that I have to acquire new kochos or eradicate certain kochos. No. I just have to rechannel. What a different way to approach. It's a different model of change. It's a different, now it could be still the same level of comprehensive personalistic change, but Lamaisa, what a difference between telling someone you have to change versus telling someone, when I say someone I mean myself, right, telling yourself you have to channel. Not you have to change, you have to channel. That's what something incredible. He goes on, he says, Ki ein lecha shum midah v'koach. He says, there is no midah, and here he brings in midah, those character traits, koach, energy. And he writes in Birur Chasidus, afilu hamidos utchunos hanefesh aniros agruos biyoser. Even the most disgusting and terrible and lowly midos, kigon achzorius v'kas. Achzorius, again, remember, is like a indifferent evil, right? A total indifference, a cruelty, kas, anger. She'in ba tzad tov gamkin, that doesn't have some type of positive byproduct as well. Kigon lis achzer b'mokum she'in ratzon Hashem yisparach l'rachim. For example, he says, for the ability to be cruel where HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't want me to be kind. So we'll say, so we'll see that we're going to see this in a little bit in Meretz Hashem. We'll get to this example. But Reb Tzadik is going to show that there are circumstances where you need achzarius. You need to be cruel. There are times in life that you need to be cruel. And if you don't possess that midah at all, you will get yourself in trouble. The shaila just is where to utilize your midah of achzarius, your midah of cruelty, and when, of course, to channel it a little bit differently. He goes on, he says, Rak tzarech ha'adam liros, keitzad lifal b'chol midah m'midosav, la'asiyas ratzan Hashem. Rather, they both say the challenge of life is to figure out when to use each of the different midos in the service of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Kach she'ishtamish ba b'chol tchuna u'mida she'yesh b'nafsho, kafi ratzon Hashem yizbarach. V'zeu tzat hatov sheba. So again, Reb Tzadik espouses something that we've seen before. We've seen before, we've learned before, but here Reb Tzadik is really going to delve into it in a dramatic fashion. There is no such thing as a bad midah, and there is no such thing as a bad koach. Every midah has its place, and every koach, every source of strength that we possess is needed to be utilized in different circumstances. The challenge of life is learning how to challenge our midos and our kochos in the right way. He goes on, he says, we'll just do another couple of lines. Vim eino mishtamish bitchunos nafsho, kafi ratzon Hashem yisparach. Actually, I'll both say, we'll stop over here for today. We're going to begin tomorrow morning. We're going to see some dramatic examples. So we'll say, here, Reb Tzadik outlined this. Just the flow, after I know that chutzpah is good, that totally blew my mind, right? Chutzpah is good. Spent my life hearing chutzpah is bad, which then creates for us a brand new paradigm, which says, Reb Tzadik, there's no such thing as a bad midah, no such thing as a bad koach. Life is just all about channeling the kochos and the midos you have in the right way. Now, I want to point out to you just, and again, we'll see the examples tomorrow. When you begin to see the examples, it'll begin to take frame a little bit more. But I just want to point out to you that at the end of the day, not everybody agrees with what Reb Tzadik is saying. For example, the Rambam brings down in Hilchos Deos that there are certain midos that a person should not have, certain midos megunos. Amongst them, the Rambam says, kas. The Rambam says there's no room for kas. Which is very interesting. So I'm just pointing out to you that not everyone subscribes to this idea. In Reb Tzadik's model, which again is the Baal Shem, it's already early, these are the tenets of Chassidus, everything that HaKadosh Baruch Hu creates me with, by definition, is Tov. It's just a shaila of how I use it. Versus outside of Chassidic thought, there's definitely this mindset that, no, there are certain things which are inherently bad, and you need to eradicate them from within you. Samir Tzashem, we'll stop over for today. We'll continue on this journey tomorrow. Shkach HaBasai.